there are many different factors that can contribute to someone having an increased risk of developing breast cancer. Examples would include such things as a strong family history of breast cancer, a genetic mutation that might predispose you to developing breast cancer, such as a BRCA1 or 2 mutation, or a personal history of a breast biopsy that showed atypical cells, such as ADH, ALH, or LCIS. An average woman's risk of developing breast cancer over the course of her lifetime is about 12%, and anyone with an estimated lifetime risk of greater than 20% is considered to be at high risk of developing breast cancer. There are many different risk models that we can use to calculate a woman's estimated lifetime risk of developing breast cancer. An evaluation by a provider in a high-risk breast clinic or genetic counseling clinic can help facilitate this. The risk models provide an estimated risk, and if your risk is estimated to be greater than 20%, we would discuss various options for how to manage this increased risk. Well, first and foremost, I would recommend that you establish care with a high-risk breast clinic so that you can be formally evaluated. For some patients, genetic testing may be appropriate if they have a strong family history of breast cancer. For many patients with increased risk of developing breast cancer, we would typically recommend an enhanced imaging surveillance with mammography plus MRI, generally alternating every 6 months. For some patients, chemo prevention or taking medication to help reduce risk of breast cancer may be appropriate. And for other patients, risk-reducing surgery, such as bilateral prophylactic mastectomy, may be appropriate. For patients that are at increased risk of developing breast cancer, we typically always recommend enhanced imaging surveillance. This is the idea that imaging will catch something at the earliest possible stage if cancer were to develop. With respect to things that we can do to actively reduce risk of developing breast cancer, there are options, including taking medication to reduce risk. Tamoxifen and aromatase inhibitors are medications that we actually use to treat breast cancer, but they can also be used to help prevent breast cancer in women who are at high risk. These medications will reduce the risk of developing breast cancer by approximately 50%. If you are at high risk, it is important to have a discussion with your doctor regarding the benefits and side effects of these medications. Typically, they would be taken for 5 years. Risk-reducing surgery with bilateral prophylactic mastectomy is also an option, and this reduces risk of developing breast cancer by about 95%. If you are considering bilateral prophylactic mastectomy, you should meet with both a breast surgeon as well as a plastic surgeon to discuss reconstructive options. This is a very personal decision, and everyone comes to this decision differently. I would recommend that you are evaluated in a high-risk breast clinic just so that you can discuss all of the options very thoroughly and in great detail, and really come to the decision that works best for you.